President Trump's pick to lead the CIA, Gina Hapsel, reportedly offered to withdraw her nomination after a White House meeting focusing on her past role in interrogation programs, according to The Washington Post. The Post, citing four senior U.S. officials, reports that Hapsel had advised the White House she would withdraw to avoid a potentially harsh confirmation hearing, which is set for Wednesday before the Senate Intelligence Committee. Officials told the Post she didn't want to risk damaging the reputation of the CIA and herself in the process. One official, the Post writes, said that Hapsel reportedly said that she didn't want to be the next Ronnie Jackson, referring to Mr. Trump's failed nominee for Veterans Affairs Secretary who withdrew his nomination amid allegations of misconduct while serving in the White House medical unit. However, CBS News senior investigative producer Pat Milton reports that a source close to the matter said that Hapsel's nomination is going forward. An administration official also told CBS News that her nomination remains on track, a CIA spokesperson said in a statement to CBS News. Those who know the true Gina Hapsel, who worked with her, who served with her, who helped her confront terrorism, Russia and countless other threats to our nation, they almost uniformly support her. The statement added, that is true for people who disagree about nearly everything else. There is a reason for that. When the American people finally have a chance to see the true Gina Hapsel on Wednesday, they will understand why she is so admired and why she is and will be a great leader for this agency. Hapsel is the first woman nominated to head the CIA, but that has been overshadowed by the controversy surrounding her involvement with the agency's enhanced interrogation program implemented in the aftermath of 9/11, as well as her reported role in overseeing a black site in Thailand, where interrogations of high-level terrorist suspects were carried out in 2002. The CIA has since declassified and sent to Congress an 8-page disciplinary review memorandum that cleared Hapsel of any wrongdoing in the destruction of videotapes made of interrogations of Al-Qaeda detainees. The memo obtained by CBS News places responsibility for the destruction of 92 tapes on Jose Rodriguez Jr., then the head of the agency's Directorate of Operations, while noting Hapsel drafted the cable authorizing the measure. It was during a White House meeting on Friday that Hapsel was reportedly grilled on her history with the interrogation program and signaled she would withdraw her nomination. Officials told the Post that White House aides including Mark Short and Sarah Huckabee Sanders met with Hapsel at her CIA office for private discussions afterwards. The White House has since voiced their confidence in Hapsel, with Sanders tweeting on Saturday that there was no one more qualified to be the first woman to lead the CIA than 30-year CIA veteran Gina Hapsel. She also slammed Democrats who support women's empowerment but oppose Hapsel's nomination as hypocrites. There is no one more qualified to be the first woman to lead the CIA than 30-year CIA veteran Gina Hapsel. Any Democrat who claims to support women's empowerment and our national security but opposes her nomination is a total hypocrite, Sarah Sanders, at PressIC, May 5, 2018. White House Principal Deputy Press Secretary Rod Shaw echoed Sanders in a statement on Sunday. Acting Director Hapsel is a highly qualified nominee who has dedicated over 3 decades of service to her country. Her nomination will not be derailed by partisan critics who side with the ACLU over the CIA on how to keep the American people safe. On Monday, Mr. Trump himself lent his support to Hapsel, tweeting that she's come under fire because she was too tough on terrorists. My highly respected nominee for CIA director, Gina Hapsel, has come under fire because she was too tough on terrorists. Think of that, in these very dangerous times, we have the most qualified person, a woman, who Democrats want out because she is too tough on terror. Win Gina, Donald J. Trump, at Real Donald Trump, May 7, 2018, he added, think of that, in these very dangerous times, we have the most qualified person, a woman, who Democrats want out, because she is too tough on terror. Win Gina, Hapsel has been doing damage control of her own. According to Michael Morrill, former CIA deputy director and CBS News contributor, Hapsel has told senators in private meetings that she would never let the CIA restart an interrogation and detention program. She has said that she will abide by the legal framework governing interrogations detailed in the Army Field Manual. Hapsel is also promising to ensure that the CIA remains focused on its core mission of collection and analysis and that the agency abides by its values of service, integrity and courage. Speaking on Morrill's Intelligence Matters podcast, former CIA and NSA director Michael Hayden expressed his support for Hapsel's nomination. We know some mistakes were made, Hayden said of the enhanced interrogation program, but at its core, we thought the program met all the requirements the agency had to have to do those kinds of things. Hayden added, there is no way that an agency officer of Gina's character and experience will send CIA officers out there to do this again. CBS News' Olivia Gazzese contributed to this report.